Welcome back, dear students. Once again, I am here with you all to continue with the partnership accounts. Hope in the last session, you all remember, I taught you the two core concepts of admission of a partner. And one was how to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. And the second one was how to calculate sacrificing ratio. Having seen these two basic concepts, now we are going into the various adjustments which we need to be giving for reconstitution of the firm. In the sense, we want to adjust the books of accounts when the new partner has joined. So, what are the various accounting treatments which we are supposed to give? Then there I told you that we have to give the adjustment for capital brought by new partner. There will be accumulated profits, revaluation. All these adjustments I am going to cover in this session. And every adjustment, that is every treatment, I am going to teach you with journal entry and their effect. So in this session, my focus is to teach you the concept. And in next session, I'll continue with the problems. That is, whatever we are learning today in this session, application part will be done in the next session. So, first treatment. I told you that whenever a partner joins the firm, whenever a new partner, incoming partner, he comes into the firm, I said he acquires two rights, I told you. One, he is going to share the future profits. And one, he is going to have the right on the assets because he is introducing money, cash, which we call as capital. So, whenever a partner joins the firm, he brings capital. He brings capital. And this is a very basic journal entry. Last year in sole proprietorship also we saw when business is started, cash to capital. But here, already business is started. He is just joining the firm. So, entry is cash account debit to capital account. Now, how to give the effect? In the account, there are two accounts involved. One is cash account and one is capital account. So, in cash account, we are going to post on debit side. Whereas, in capital account, that is in new partner's capital account, we will post on credit side. Dear students, please keep in mind, it is all the game of the journal entry and the ledger posting. If you are perfect with the ledger posting and the journal entry, you can do the admission of a partner very easily. So, whenever the new partner brings capital, 100% there will be the first adjustment. For example, Raju is admitted as a new partner for 1/4 share, for which he brought 40,000 as capital. That will be 100% for sure. So, immediately in your mind, you should make a entry. And entry will be what? Cash account debit to Raju's capital account. Then effect. Cash account debit side. We'll write to Raju's capital. Then we'll go to partner's capital by cash in Raju's column. Again, this is the first treatment. Then comes the next treatment, which is all about accumulated profits and losses. Now, sir, what do we mean by accumulated profit? What do we mean by accumulated loss? So, first I am going to teach you accumulated profits. How, sir? Generally, we know that every firm, it earns profit. It earns profit. And what they will do with that profit? Do you think all the profit they are going to distribute and consume? No. Let us go for a while to the sources of finance of inter first year commerce. There we studied about retained earnings. And what we told about retained earnings? A portion of profit is kept aside. Why it is kept aside? To meet the future contingencies. Like that, even in partnership firm, every year, whatever profit the partners they are earning, okay, some portion of the profit the partners will keep aside, and that amount of profit which is kept aside, it gets accumulated, means it gets added. And how that profit is kept? That profit is kept in the form of general reserve, reserve fund, or profit and loss balance. Please keep these three words in mind. Whenever you see in the problem general reserve, reserve fund, or profit and loss account, you will tell these are the accumulated profits. And where they appear? They appear on the liability side. Why they appear on liability side? They are kept for some purpose, I told. Thereby, it is a liability. So, whenever a new partner joins, he has no right to ask for the previous profit. So, what the old partners will do now? Because those profits were earned by them, they are going to distribute among themselves. Okay? Compulsory. These undistributed profit, accumulated profit or undistributed, they will be in form of what? General reserve, reserve fund, or profit and loss account. And where they appear? They appear on liabilities side. So, what we should do? It should be compulsorily distributed among old partners in old ratio. So, what is the entry? Accumulated profits account debit to old partners capital account. Accumulated profit account debit to old partners capital account. This we are going to prepare as account number one when we'll do main problem. Keep in mind, for example, if they give general reserve, then general reserve account debit to old partners. Let me say two old partners are there, X and Y. So, to X capital to Y capital. Like that, let me say they told prof reserve fund. So, we'll substitute reserve fund account debit to Rosy capital account to Gold capital account. Like that, whatever names of the partners are given, we are going to distribute. Then what will be the effect, sir? In that particular account, that is in the accumulated profit account, on debit side will write two old partners, that is their name will write individually, and in partners will write by accumulated profit. Next important point. This accumulated profit is a liability. Keep in mind, liabilities, they show credit balance, and I told we'll prepare account. So, whenever we prepare any accumulated profit account, that accumulated profit amount will write in that account on credit side by balance brought down. That I am going to teach you in detail again when I'll solve the problems. So, this is accumulated profit. What are the three suitable examples of accumulated profit? General reserve, reserve fund, profit and loss account. These are the three accumulated profits. Where they appear? Liabilities side. And what we should do? Compulsorily, they should be distributed among old partners in old profit ratio. Then, sir, what are accumulated losses? Same like accumulated profits, we'll have even accumulated losses. In the sense, those losses which we have not distributed and we kept them aside. And what they are? They appear on which side? Asset side of the balance sheet. Asset side of balance sheet. That is debit balance we call. They are the debit balances of what, sir? Like debit balance of profit and loss. Don't get confused. When I say accumulated profit, it is credit balance of profit and loss. When I say debit balance of profit and loss, it is accumulated loss. Like that, we have advertisement, suspense, deferred revenue expenditure. These are accumulated losses. And even these accumulated losses, they will be distributed among old partners. Compulsorily, they will be distributed among old partners. And what is the journal entry? Old partners capital account debit to accumulated losses account. Say for instance, sir, on asset side, they gave advertisement suspense. Advertisement suspense. Then what will be the entry? And there are two partners. Let me say for example, Anil and Sunil. So, Anil account debit, Sunil account debit to advertisement suspense account. We'll do the calculation. How much each gets the share? How to calculate the shares? I taught you in the first session when I taught you profit and loss appropriation. Again, I'm going to show you. So, effect. Where we'll show the effect? In this partner's capital account debit side, we'll write two advertisement suspense or, for example, deferred. So, two deferred. And in the account, we'll write on the credit side. Then, sir, you told that accumulated profits, they show credit balance. So, in that account, we wrote by balance. So, whenever there is accumulated loss, that will be account number 2. And that will show debit side. 2 balance brought down. Because asset, asset shows debit balance. Okay, this is about accumulated profit and accumulated loss. Again, I am showing you the slide of accumulated profit dear. Just have a look. Because this is the base. Accumulated profit treatment is what? Distribute among old partners in old profit ratio. Then, capital brought in by new partner, cash to capital. Then, comes accumulated loss. What is accumulated loss treatment? Any accumulated loss which is appearing on asset side of the balance sheet must be distributed among old partners in old ratio. Entry is here. Then, next comes the most important treatment, which is about 80% of your solution and all about revaluation of assets and liabilities. Sir, what do you mean by revaluation of assets and liabilities? I hope you all remember, I gave you an example. Admission of a partner with the example that your brother is getting married. And what you'll do? If you want to celebrate or perform marriage in the home, generally what we'll do before marriage? We'll do all the cleaning work and all. Right? We'll try to set all the things properly. Let me say there is an old sofa. What you'll do with that old sofa? You will try to put it away. That is, you want to discard or repair it or something you will do. Like that, let me say there are some walls which are not proper or curtains are not proper. What you will do, dear? We all will try to reassess them. We will try to bring them to their good position. Like that, even in admission of a partner, whenever a new partner is going to join the firm, that time, what we will do better? We all will try to revalue the assets and liabilities. Revaluing means what? Trying to bring assets and liabilities to their correct market value. We'll try to bring them to their correct market value. So, here is the meaning of revaluation and revaluation account. Don't get confused with revaluation and account. Both are different. Revaluation means, you know that because of the time gap, assets, what will happen? Either they will increase in their value or decrease in their value. Like that, even the liabilities will increase or decrease. So, finding out the increase or decrease in the value of asset or liability and bringing them to their original value, that is proper value, is called revaluation. Okay? Last line you see. The process of bringing assets and liabilities to their proper value is called revaluation. And to bring this assets and liabilities, what we'll do? We will revalue them. In the sense, their increased value or decreased value, we are going to account in a special account which we call as revaluation account. We'll call it as revaluation account, which is very much similar to profit and loss account. What is the rule of profit and loss account? Debit all expense, credit all incomes. So, whatever is decreasing or increasing, that we have to adjust in revaluation account. So, what we'll call that? Revaluation account is nothing but it is the miniature of profit and loss account, and it is of which account nature? Nominal account. Now see here, in the content only I gave you the entire thing. Decrease in the value of asset. Please keep in mind, if the value of asset decreases or if value of liability increases, we have to show on debit side. We have to show on debit side. Decrease in asset, increase in liability, we'll show on debit side. Then increase in value of asset, decrease in value of liability, will show on credit side of revaluation account. And the difference, whatever we get, we'll call it as profit or loss. When we'll call it as profit, you know, when credit total is more than debit total, we'll get profit. And that profit will be distributed among old partners. In which ratio? Old ratio. Like the debit side total we got more, we'll get loss. That will distribute among partners. Now, how to do so? So, I'll show with journal entry. So, here are the journal entries for you all. Now, here are the journal entries with the effects. What are the journal entries? Whenever the asset value increases, if there is increase in value of asset, means appreciation, appreciation. Entry is asset account debit to revaluation account. What is the effect now? We'll show the appreciation amount on revaluation account credit side. Already I told you, value of asset is increasing. So, show on revaluation account credit side. And what we'll do? That amount, whatever has increased, will add to the asset. Say, for example, they told building appreciated. So, building account debit to revaluation account. Like that, when there is decrease in value of asset, in the sense depreciation. Depreciation along with bad debts also you can call here. So, the entry will be revaluation account debit to asset account. What are the effects? We'll show on revaluation account debit side and we'll subtract from the related asset. Simultaneously, please make a note also, dear. Then, third entry. What is the third entry we are telling? There is an unrecorded asset. What is an unrecorded asset? We might have forgot to record an asset. Okay, we bought the asset, but in the books we did not write. We forgot. Today we came to know that there is a record asset which we remained unrecorded. So whenever there is unrecorded asset, we'll write the entry unrecorded asset. Why? We forgot the asset. We are bringing into the book. So value of asset is increasing. So unrecorded asset account debit to revaluation account. What is the effect? We'll show on the revaluation account credit side and balance sheet asset side. Again, I am telling dear student, these entries, that is revaluation entries, are the 80% of your solution. One who knows revaluation, six entries are there. Three of what? Assets. Then I'll show liabilities. So simultaneously, please make a note and focus on the effects. That effects will guide you to do the problem in a very systematic manner. So, these are the entries for assets. One, appreciation, that is increase. Depreciation, decrease, unrecorded. With effects and things. So, whenever there is appreciation in asset, show on revaluation account credit side, add to asset in the new balance sheet. Decrease, revaluation account debit side, subtract from asset. Unrecorded asset, credit side of revaluation account and show in the balance sheet asset side. Then comes the next part of the journal entry. The three entries were from which point of view? Assets point of view. Now we are learning from liabilities point of view. Again, increase in value of liability. Liability is increasing. When liability increases, what is the journal entry? Revaluation account debit to liability account. Then what are the effects? This particular liability, whatever has increased, first we'll show on the debit side of the revaluation account and we'll add to the related liability. How? Say for example, In the question, they may say, creditors increased by 5,000. So, creditors, we'll add to creditors. How much? 5,000. What will be the journal entry? Revaluation account debit to creditors account. Like the decrease in liability, when liability is reducing, if at all any liability decreases, how we are going to account? Then liability account debit to revaluation. Already liability shows credit balance. So it is reduced. So we are debiting. Then FX. Subtract from the related liability and show on revaluation account credit side. Only that particular amount. Then unrecorded liability. We might have forgotten to record any liability. Later we realized. So revaluation account debit to unrecorded liability account. Effect will be what? Will show on the revaluation account credit debit side, and in the new balance sheet will show on asset side. So these six entries, three of what? Three of asset, three of liabilities. We are going to put in which account I told? Revaluation account. And once we post them into revaluation account, we'll come to know whether there is profit or loss. And what is the rule of profit I told? If the credit side of revaluation is more, we'll get profit. If debit side is more, we'll get loss. And for that, we have the entries here. What we are going to do with that profit or loss? It should be distributed among the partners. Which partners? Old partners. For that, entries are here. When there is profit, revaluation to old partners. With their share, I wrote. Like that, effect is given. Where we'll show? In revaluation account, debit side. And second effect, we'll put in the partner's account, credit side. Then if there is loss, then entry will be reversed. Old partner's capital account debit to revaluation account. So these are the entries. Please focus on these entries and simultaneously make a note of these entries. Again, I'm repeating, one who knows these entries will be able to solve the problem very easily. So, let me show you once again the entries for your revaluation. Entries for your revaluation dear. Increase in value of asset, decrease in value of asset, unrecorded asset. When there is increase in value of asset, asset to revaluation, effect, add to asset, show at revaluation account, credit side. When there is decrease in value of asset, revaluation account debit to asset account, effect, show at revaluation account debit side, subtract from related asset. Second one, be careful. Depreciation, when I say, it will be for stock, furniture, bad debts, that is on debtors, it will be for that. Then, unrecorded asset. Whenever there is unrecorded asset, like they'll tell unrecorded investment, unrecorded plant, machinery, anything, then effect is unrecorded asset to revaluation. And new balance sheet will show as asset and revaluation account, credit side. Then the entries for liability side. Increase in value of liability, decrease in value of liability, unrecorded liability. Entries you know. Effects you can check here. If there is increase, revaluation to liability, entry, revaluation to liability, effect will add to the related liability and show on the debit side. Whereas decrease, if it is there, will subtract and will show on revaluation account credit side. Then unrecorded liability, nothing but it is increase in liability. So same effect again will show on the revaluation account debit side and in the balance sheet liability side. Profit and loss. It should be distributed among partners. This is all about revaluation. This is all about revaluation. Now comes the next part called goodwill. In this session, I'll just explain the meaning of goodwill. Accounting treatment I'm going to show in the next session. So treatment for goodwill. What do you mean goodwill? Goodwill is nothing but the reputation. Goodwill is reputation. Every person in this society, he has reputation. And how that reputation is earned? That reputation you can earn only because of your hard work. Keep in mind. So even in business, because of the hard work of the businessman, because of the honesty of the businessman, because of his connections with the other people, he will earn reputation. And that reputation is called goodwill. Now, sir, what goodwill will help us? Goodwill is something which is intangible, which you cannot see, dear, which you cannot see. And that goodwill is going to help you, that is, it will help your business to earn the profits which are over and above the normal profit. Anyone can earn normal profit. Anybody can earn normal profit. But those firms which have goodwill, like for example, Reliance. Today, Reliance has a very good name in the market. Like that Bajaj, it has very good name. Like that, they are earning which profits? Then we call they earn super profits. They earn super profits. So, 2 marks they will ask you. Goodwill. So, this is the meaning you are going to write. Goodwill is good name, wide connection of business, or reputation of business earned by businessmen through hard work and honesty. It is the reputation of the firm which can be in respect of profits and helps to earn which profit? Super profit. Then what are the characteristics? Here the characters are there. It is intangible. You cannot see the goodwill. And what happened? It will fluctuate. It has the tendency of getting fluctuated. Means according to the profits, your goodwill will also increase and decrease. Let me say for example, in your school also, in your college also, you have goodwill. If you are scoring above 35, let me say you have scored 90, so your goodwill will be more. Let me say in second unit test, you have scored only 20, your goodwill will reduce. Like that constant fluctuations. Then, it is, its valuation is what? Subjective. In the sense, many factors are there which determines goodwill. So, whenever like a teacher wants to appreciate you, what they will do? Only your marks they will take criteria? No. They will see other factors also. How honest you are. How humble you are. How disciplined you are. Like that, even goodwill is a subjective matter. So, in this session, these are the factors which determines the goodwill. Nature of the business, location, where you are establishing your business, what type of business you are doing, your market situation, how the market situation is, whether it is on the boon or on the depression side, then your management efficiency, your political conditions, your brand image, your government regulations, all these are the factors which we determines the value of your business, that is goodwill. Why we want to value the goodwill? Need. Okay? Then whenever there is admission of a partner, when there is retirement, when there is death or change in the profit ratio, or when two partnership firms they are going to mix together. Like that, we have the need. Then methods. Of course, the first method is important for 2 marks, which I am going to cover up in the second, that is upcoming session. So, here we have methods of valuation. So, next session, I am going to cover the problems on simple average profit method along with the treatment for goodwill. Hope you all have understood this session. Okay. Revise the journal entries, what I taught in this session today with regards to the revaluation account. So that when we do the problems, it will be easy for you all, dear, to catch the problem and solve it in a very easy manner. So, we'll meet very soon in the next session. Till that time, stay safe, stay at home. God bless you all. Thank